Minneapolis, the public school board has adopted a gender inclusion policy for the district that will be put in place next year. The new policy will mean students can use whatever restroom or locker room they choose, as well as participate in sports according to their gender identity. Sammy Salina has more on an issue that has been divisive around the country.
That motion carries and the policy is approved.
Unanimously, the Minneapolis School Board passes its gender inclusion policy.
Ecstatic.
Relieved.
Tears of joy.
Yes.
Anna L. and Claire Trolley are parents of transgender, non-binary, and gender-fluid kids in the district who they say have been bullied and lacked access to support.
It was wonderful to hear the comments from a couple of school board members saying, hey, this is something to celebrate.
The policy ensures access to restrooms and locker rooms that align with the student's gender identity. It recognizes their right to be referred to at a school by a chosen name and pronouns, and that they're able to participate in school activities like sports in a manner that is consistent with gender identity. Training for staff would be provided.
It's really just establishing a baseline that says our kids have a right to access changing facilities and bathrooms without being attacked.
Just last week, a transgender girl at Hopkins High was using the men's restroom. After a tense exchange, police are investigating allegations of racial and transgender slurs spoken by both sides before she was punched in the face. She spent 2 days in the hospital.
I mean, the second you have a child who comes out as anything but cisgendered and straight, that is the fear that moves into your heart and never moves away.
Opportunities for All Kids, a school choice group, says the policy is concerning because of safety issues for all students in bathrooms and locker rooms.
Does that mean a boy could be in my girl's bathroom? By the policy, yes.
Devin Foley, the group's executive director, says it forces parents into a divisive policy.
An enormous amount of energy is spent on a gender inclusion policy when less than half of the kids are proficient in reading.
This is asking for like such the bare minimum. This is bringing them up to an equal level. This is not asking for extra or special treatment.
We have seen this divisiveness with similar issues even recently, but I went through the two school board meetings where this was discussed, and no one, over hours of public comment, spoke out against the policy. Randy.